Or you might know it's here, but because I told you.
Okay. So, as I've told you, this is our last class. It's 5:15, so we're done with the journal entry for today. And really, we're done with journaling for this whole semester because today is our final class that we're meeting, even though we were originally going to be going till next week. But I'm giving you a week off so that you can do your papers, your art projects. Does everyone have a lot of studio work to do still? Is anyone done?
One.
You're done one of your studio classes? Yeah. How many do you have?
That's a forum class, not studio class.
So you're done one forum class.
Yeah.
But everyone still has studio work. And Yoonji, do you have, is it this Friday, your art exhibit?
No.
No. It's the 10th, right?
Yeah, no, just 7th through 10th, but it's not only for me, just everyone is.
Oh, I know, it's not everyone. But you're going to be there?
No.
Oh. I'm not going to, I was going to try to stop by. I'm not going to see you.
Oh, really? I don't know what time should I be there because she didn't decide it.
Okay. But Friday's the 10th, right? I'm not wrong.
No, 7th. So Thursday through Sunday.
Yeah, I was gonna see if I could stop by on Friday. But you won't be there?
I'm not sure.
I'll think about it. Does anyone else have their work being shown? What is it called?
No, it's not an exhibition, just an art market.
Oh, the art market. So you're selling. So you're hoping to make money. Is anyone else selling any work? No, not yet. Okay, so let me just recap. We're done with the journal. Today, all we're going to do is have a shortened class. We're going to review what we went over this semester. Just do a little recap to jog your memories. Hopefully this helps either solidify things that you forgot that we talked about, or maybe it can help you during some of your editing phases as you're finishing your final papers for your critical inquiry classes. So I'm going to ask you questions, and I'm going to pick on people if I don't get people raising their hands, and I'm not going to let Grace answer all the questions, but I will let you answer a lot. So when we started this semester, we talked about different types of writing styles. Does anyone remember what we talked about? Think way back to the beginning of class.
RCAC.
Say again?
RCAC.
I can't hear you. Oh, persuasive, yes. Can you describe what is persuasive?
Like you're convincing someone else.
Convincing, good. You're trying to persuade or convince someone in your writing. Great. That was one of the four. Any more?
Descriptive.
Descriptive, yes. And what is that?
You're describing.
You're describing, good. Another one starts with an E. Any ideas? It's the one where you're talking about, you're just informing and giving information, which is probably what many of your papers have been. You're writing about. Expository. And that's probably what most of your papers, well, maybe not most of, but a lot of your papers have been. And there's one more that we don't often use. Narrative, good. And what is that?
Using first or second perspective?
Yeah, when you're, exactly. If you're writing kind of like a dialogue and you're writing he said, she said, I said, but you're writing like a script, almost like you're writing a play. That could be narrative, or you could just, it could just be part of your story. It doesn't have to be a script for anything. Hi, welcome. Welcome to our last day of class. Did you bring your computer?
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, so we're just reviewing what we went over this semester, and then we're gonna, oh, and I didn't finish our plan. So we'll review, and then we will do a peer edit of a paper just briefly, and then I'm going to have you do your evaluations, and then I'll kick you out. I'll let you go. Okay, so perfect. So that was one of the things we covered in the beginning. What's an essay include, or what does an essay include? I'm looking for three things. Why hello? Everyone's popping in a little late. What does an essay include?
Intro, body,
and good. Great. Writing process. What are some of the steps of the writing process that we talked about? There are more steps, but I'm looking for three in particular. What do you do when you first get an assignment?
Brainstorming.
Great. Brainstorming.
Outline. What?
And then you outline.
And then start. Right.
And then you write. And then what do you do when you're done writing?
Citation.
Say it again?
Citation.
Well, you can include citations in your writing. Good.
Proofreading
or editing at the end. And really, you can be doing that throughout the whole time. Good. Okay. Okay. How do we handle long reading assignments? There are different ways to handle them, but what are three of the things I talked about, some tips for handling? If you get a reading assignment that's maybe 50 pages long, which may happen down the road, can you read that all in a week with your other homework? Not necessarily. Kenny, can you? Maybe not. So what are some techniques you would use if you can't read everything because you just physically don't have enough time? Think about what we've done. During the class, I gave you a long printout, handout, and I said I had give you 2 minutes to read it or 3 minutes to read it. What did you do? Heard it. Take a guess. Well, just think it through. Even if you don't have the right words, I'm not looking. Quickly go through the reading and so you can preview is one of the words. I heard another word was skim. Good. And scan is the same, pretty much the same term. So if we're skimming, we're just briefly reading. Sometimes you use your finger to follow along and just skim through. If you're scanning for any particular word, if you're looking for a specific subject, you can look for a word and have it try to make that pop out, and then you can read that paragraph a little bit more in depth. Right. Good. Can you kick that? Remember last time? Someone kicked the radiator for us. Just kick it. One more time. One more little kick. I think it's better, right? Okay. Good. So, just so you know, you're not always expected to read if you have 50 pages worth of reading. Conjunctions. Can one of you two tell me what you think conjunctions are? Brief summary. Those are two examples. What do they do?
Connect.
Good. They connect sentences or thoughts together. And we'll talk about different types of sentences in a minute. Good. Do you remember the movie, the video we watched? What was it called? Who was singing it? Sharon, is that you?
Oh, yeah, I think that's me.
Do you remember what it was called?
Disney something. What, you mean the title of the video? I don't remember. I only know the songs.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
Yeah, that one.
Okay. So then they connect clauses or sentences together. The most common ones can be remembered with this acronym, FANBOYS. And then Eugene Meishuan said for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so. So those are the most common ones. And conjunctions, remember, they can either make a sentence, make the two clauses agree with each other, or connect them in in regards to the same ideas. So this and this, or they can say this nor this, or they can say this might happen, but this other thing might happen. So they're a good transition to a different thought if you use one of those conjunctions. What are articles? Actually, Kenny, I want to ask you, because last time I told you I was going to ask you. And if I didn't tell you, I knew you struggled with it for a minute. So tell me what articles are. Give me an example first. Say again. The? Is that what you said? Yeah. The. What's another? So if I say I'm going to the Spanish class, I'm specifically talking about one Spanish class in, that I have in my mind. The Spanish class
like
that's held at 1 o'clock.
Like,
and what'd you say?
A
or an. Good. So if I'm talking about a Spanish class, it could be any Spanish class. If I'm talking about the Spanish class, I'm talking about that specific Spanish class that I have in my head. And then an is used just like a, but instead of, or why would you use an? Someone else can help them out. An versus a. Good, a vowel. So a or a, A-E-I-O-U. So if it's, so if you have a vowel, come on then. Settle in, and then I'm going to ask you a hard question. So yes, exactly, Mary. So if you have a vowel, a noun that starts with a vowel, you would use an. Or if you have a word that sounds like it starts like with a vowel, like the word with the letter M sometimes, and M and M, you would say an. Good. Okay. So art. Ooh. And like I said, it goes before a vowel, it acts like an adjective, it's describing, it can help describe the vowel. It can also highlight, count, and Mary, this is kind of what you were getting hung up on just in that paper a minute ago, count versus non-count nouns. So if you have a noun that, like water, for example, you don't have to say a water because that's a non-count vowel. You don't have to say a air, right? It's just, in general, you say air. Air smells, well, you could say the air if you're talking about specific air, or